Welcome to online classes. Today we will start with arrays part 2. Our chapter 8 is about multidimensional arrays. In our previous chapter we have studied about how we can initialize, manipulate, copy and track the elements of an array. But in this chapter we'll study even further how we can create tables, matrices with an array. Ordinary arrays are indexed by a single integer. In the concept of multidimensional array, in which we index the array using an ordered list of integer. What do you understand by ordered list? A list in a sequence, such as example, an array is initialized A with 3 rows and 3, 1 and 5. The number of integers in the list used to index into multidimensional array is always the same and is referred to as array's dimensionality. Means that dimensionality is different and the bounds on each of these are called the array dimensions. Basically saying, in another variables, if we are using rows and columns, tables and etc., their variables are called dimensions. An array with dimensionality k is often called k-dimensional. Alright, it depends on number of dimensions. One-dimensional arrays are correspondent to a simple array discussed thus so far in our previous chapter. Two-dimensional arrays are particularly common representation of matrices or tables, complex numbers. The dimensionality of an array rarely exceeds 3. Alright, it is very rare we can exceed more than 3-dimensional arrays. Mapping one-dimensional array into memory is obvious, since memory is logically itself a very large or one-dimensional array. If the number of subscripts is more than 1, then such arrays are called multi-dimensional arrays. For example, in here, array. In our previous chapter, we studied about first example, defined an array 1 with square within square brackets, that is one dimensional array. But in this chapter, we'll study about two dimensional and three dimensional arrays. Okay, programmer writes the number of elements between the square brackets that will be used for the function of the program. In the below part, two dimensional array has been discussed in detail. So it's really important, pay attention. Two-dimensional array. It is an ordered table of homogeneous elements. Same kind. It is generally referred to as matrix or some rows and some columns. Number of columns and number of rows. It is also called as two subscripted variables. Alright, there are two subscripted variables in an two-dimensional array. Syntax, how we can declare two-dimensional array? We declare data type, int, float, char, etc. And then type, array name. We have to write an array name, A, B, C, whatever you want to give. And then number of rows you want to add and number of columns. Alright, where rows, number of elements that will be processed under subscript 1 into one side, and columns will be subscript 2. For example, here integer, float and character are data types, and these are names and there are two values. 5 rows, 13 columns. 3 rows, 3 columns, 25 rows and 80 columns. Let us see representation of two-dimensional array. Now, the array contains 3 rows and 4 columns, correct? So it is said to be by 3 by 4. If you are processing 3 by 4 value, it's automatically state that it's 3 by 4. Alright, if the value is 0 and 2 by 4, 3 by 4, it will be according to the programmer. Initialization of 2. Like we studied, this is how we initialize an array. And this is also that we can do. Like one dimensional arrays. If the number of elements to be assigned are less than total number of elements than two-dimensional array contained, then all the remaining elements are assigned zeros. Always remember, you can assign elements according to the number assigned in the array, but you cannot define more elements according to the variables passed, like this. It's only going to say as 3 or 2. Another example, similarly, inner set 1 and 2 is taken for assigning values 1 and 2 respectively for the first row of the array number, thus this. Initialization of two-dimensional array elements. Now, how we can initialize elements in two-dimensional array? Remember the following points which while dealing with initialization of two-dimensional array. Very important. The number of sets of initial values must be equal to number of rows. Okay? In the array, 1-to-1 mapping is preserved. 1-to-1 mapping is specifically preserved in here. That is, the first set of initial values is assigned to the first row elements and the second set of initial values is assigned to second row element and so on. If the number of initial values is in each initializing set is less than number of corresponding row elements, then all the elements of the row are automatically assigned to 0. Okay, if the number of initial values in each initializing set exceeds the number of corresponding row elements, then there will be a compilation error. The compiler, C compiler, won't be able to compile because you have exceeded the number of limits that you have already given. Okay, before discussing the processing of two-dimensional arrays or multi-dimensional arrays, let us see the use of nested loop. Here is an example. For, if we are saying I plus 1, initial value is increment with 1. Then checking the value, there is a problem. I is equal to 1, and then if I is less than 5, increment and then add the value, set the value. This is a loop where a new line has been added. This is an escape variable. Then another loop, inner loop. This is also called nested loop. The value of j, if the j is equal to 1 and value of j is less than is equal to 1 minus jj, and this is the output 1, 2, 3, and 4. Inner or outer loop workings, same way this table can be produced. A web code is working on this problem. Change in outer values. Inner loop got over after first iteration. First loop started with 1, the value here is 1, and then outer is saying another, is saying the value should be less than 10, and plus 1 is equal to 4. So the value here is going to be appended plus before going to 4, thus written 5 here. Then 5 goes on, the value will be 1, 3 and 5. Inner loop got over value 5 iteration. And then again 5 plus 4 is going to be 9. This is the outer value. The two-dimensional array is also called as matrix array. Okay, because it can create tables easily. In this program, an example program, look, we are initializing a value student 4, 2 and the value integers I and j. We are inputting the data and this is going to be the result. The program on the right side has two parts. The first part of the loop is used to read the values of the roll number and marks. Whereas in second part, another for loop is used to print out these values. Let us see the same example in an C program. The data in here is initialized as a student 4 rows and 2 columns. Another integer data type variables. Then outer loop is initializing the value 0. It will work if the condition is less than or equal to 3 and the increment. The screen will print enter roll number and marks. User is going to input 2 values, roll number and marks. It will be according to you if you want to input 2 values at a time or 1 value at a time. If you want to enter roll number separately and marks separately, there will be 2 more statements, printf and scanf. This loop is initializing the same value of a and putting the value into arrays. This will how the output will be. Let's say roll number 1, marks 89, roll number 2, marks 98, roll number 3, marks 67, roll number 4, marks 99. Now this is going to be the result. How do you think the table that we have created and the table in here is different? Because we have used or changed slide details. While making a C program, always remember, use your own creativity, use your own creative results. Okay? Memory occupation in two-dimensional array elements. How memory is occupied in two-dimensional array? It is almost the same as we have checked in one-dimensional array in our previous chapter. The value of this here is decided by here, or you can access any array, marks of second student. You can straight away give the location of second student, will be 33. Multi-dimensional array character type. We are moving on to multi-dimensional array, 3 dimensions or more matrices. An array of char or character with more than one subscript or size specifiers is defined as multi-dimensional array. This is a syntax. We can add story class, then character, data type, then name, straight away initializing its square brackets the elements in here. Okay, this is an example. Character, data type, a word, variable or array, array name 30 rows and 15 or carry 10s in here. In the case of 15th character, string is being the terminator backslash 0. Backslash 0 is also called an null character, empty. Accessing elements of multidimensional array. The value of elements of multidimensional array of char are accessed by specifying the name of the variable. The name of the variable that you want to access, you have to specify their name and you can access them and copy them, change them, it will be up to you. But in case of array of char or character data type, there is a difference between accessing a string. String is an function or a header function which includes statements, and accessing elements of the string which is a part of two dimensional array of char. To clarify the point, take the following example. Here, character array is initialized. The value is 2 and 3. For this, we will access character in string at row 0. And we'll access all characters in string at row 0. Okay. But in here, 0 by 0 will access first character of the first string. 0 by 2 will access string terminator, end of the first string. 1 by 0 will access first character into the second string, not the first one, okay? This is how you access strings. Initialization of char type multidimensional array. Same with an example we have studied as a syntax, char type variables, programming, computer, debug, system, about. The first subscript in the array indicates strings, programming, computer, etc. And the second subscript specifies the characters in the string. The variable words specifies the third string and the first character. The third string is debug and the first character string is D. Each string in the array words consists of 21 characters, including string terminator. The number of characters may be less than specified numbers in the array. However, the number cannot exceed the maximum value of second subscript, like we have studied earlier. In the array word, the length of string should not exceed 20 characters. Okay, being the string terminator, begin. The first subscript will vary from 0 to 4 and the second subscript from 0 to 19. If the number of characters read in is less than specified numbers with 20 in array words, the unfilled places will be filled by 0, the hexadecimal equivalent of the string terminator backslash 0 as shown in program below. The print, alright, to print these values, you need to have a string function included, a string header file included, and we will use percentage s like we used to percentage d for integer data type, percentage c for character data type, percentage f for floating data type. But to access these or print these, we use percentage s. However, the following printf statement will, C conversion will print the characters including single terminator. Two dimensional array of char word processing. In the following example, the word may be defined as sequence non-white concursion. In here, same example, inputting the data, the scanf functions terminate scanning arguments as soon as it encounters a space. Okay, you can't see, programming will not accept spaces. However, the for statement repeatedly uses the same scanf function 5 times. So, when the access is gone, it will use it 5 times again. 10 words, each word separated by least single space and read stored in array words. A simple program, try to make it out. again an example to print the elements of matrices. 3 by 3, 10 by 10. Again, the output will be determined by the programmer's attitude towards the output. To calculate the average of elements of row in two-dimensional array, single character input output. How we can input single character or output and single character? The basic operation done in input output is to read characters, that is inputting, from the standard input devices such as keyboard, and output is writing it on output devices, usually the screen. The getCharacter function can be used to read a character from standard input devices. The scanf can also be used to achieve the function. Okay, but getCharacter has the following form. We can straight away get an access from the user by using getCharacter function. Variable name is equal to getCharac. This is how you use it. Character C, printf, type the character, and we are straight away saying get the input from the user, value of C, and print C. Putchar, variable name. We can easily do it like this as well. The program read any character that you have typed on keyboard until it find A or this value dot. The buffer will be delivered to ch variable after pressing the enter key, not before this. Okay, it is about loops. Be careful about it. Put character and get character. Put character will be same as printf, but it will print all the string, the whole string in a single line. Get character will get all the string in a single line. Okay, the most important part, define directive, hash define directive. This belongs to C preprocessor category. As you can remember, we use header files or library files above the main program, a main function. We use library stdio.h, conio.h, string.h, math.h in a preprocessor defined directive. As the name itself indicates, preprocessor means that it is always be placed before compilation, hence placed before the main function. In C programming, we know that the value of variable can change as a program is executing. When the program is getting executed, the value keeps on changing, correct? But with the use of defined directive, we can keep it constant throughout the program or throughout any function that is being used. We just define hash define variable name and its value straight away with this kind of example. Define number 7. This is a variable name and its value. In other view, hash defined directive is also called macro substitution, processing of replacing an identifier of C program by constant or symbolic constants. Let's see an example here. We have defined value of PI 3.142, and we can easily find the radius in here. The value is entered by the user, radius, and PI will automatically calculate this function. Okay, any macro substitution inside the string will not be replaced, it's not going to be changed easily. Now, another simple program to get this output. If we check this in a C program, specifically like this in here, we have defined a value of, now C is case sensitive, we know that is why we have defined rows a variable name in capital letters and its value is 5, same as in columns here, before the main function. This program will be initialized by small row and small column as well. We can easily state A or B, any variable name. Product is an array which will get the values of rows and columns. Capital rows and columns will be 5 and 5. Another initialization that will check the table functions in here. Printing multiplication table, printf an empty row. For value of j is initialized from 1 and it will count till the value of columns, that will be 5, plus initialization. Same multi-dimensional array usage. Look, nested loops, it will start from 0 till the rows in here less than 5, maybe 4 times. This will be printed in the same way. Let's see the output matches. No. Always remember, the output is an outcome of programmer's confidence and the output that he wants, he or she wants. Now, this is an example program. Edit this program according to your need and make sure that the output should be as same as given in the book. It will be a good practice. Okay. Another way of initialization of multidimensional array, same with within the statement. Example, another example, increment and decrement, average. It is still replaced by same defined directive. And a summary, there are two types of arrays, one dimensional and multidimensional. One pair of square brackets is used for each dimension. For example, one dimensional array has only one subscript and it is viewed as row matrix or column matrix. But multi-dimensional arrays have one, more than one subscript. Hence, it is two-dimensional array or three-dimensional array and so on. C does not support string data types, but strings are handled as an array of character. Most important line, there is rich library of functions for manipulating strings. With this chapter, your array C programming is finished. We will be discussing strings in further studies, but you have to understand these array initializations. Try to make programs. If you want to create something, if you want to have something in mind, your creativity, use that to create new programs and new outputs. Thank you.